Dear students, now we are going to discuss orbital perturbations in detail. In satellite communication, theoretically, the Hubblerian orbit is considered as an ideal one due to the following assumptions. The first one is Earth as a perfect sphere. The next one is only the centrifugal force of satellite is balancing the gravitational pull of the Earth. But in practice, Earth is not a perfect sphere, and also there are some gravitational forces from Moon and Earth. So in practice, there are many perturbing forces present on the orbit. So perturbing forces means obstacles, okay? So here the first one is effects of non-spherical Earth. The next one is gravitational forces of the Sun and Moon with atmospheric track. Here the gravitational pulls affect the satellites in the geostationary orbit. Here it is having the negligible effect in the low orbiting Earth satellite. But at the same time, atmospheric track affects the low orbiting Earth satellites but not the geostationary orbit satellites. Okay, so let's discuss each point in detail here. The first one is effects of non-spherical Earth. So here we can consider Hubble's third law. This third law gives the relation of the mean motion, that is the nominal motion NO for a spherical Earth with uniform mass. Its value is NO is equal to square root of mu by a cube. So here we can relate the mean motion for a spherical Earth with uniform mass, but in practice Earth is not a perfect sphere. So here it is non-spherical Earth. So non-spherical means here we can use the term oblate spheroid. So next, oblate spheroid. So oblate spheroid consists of two effects. One is equatorial bulge, next one is flattening at the poles. So here we can consider the Earth like this. Okay, so in this one, there is a flatness at the poles, okay? So here, the bulge at the equatorial plane, okay? So it causes the variations in the satellite's orbit around the primary. Primary means, here we can consider Earth as a primary one. Due to the flatness in the poles as well as the bulge at the equatorial plane, the variations occurred in the satellite's orbit around the primary. Due to Earth's oblateness, the mean motion is modified as n is equal to NO into 1 plus K1 into 1 minus 1.5 sine squared I divided by A squared into 1 minus E squared the whole power 1.5. Here K1 is the constant. Its value is 66,063.1704 kilometers squared. Here the oblateness has negligible effect on semi-major axis, okay? So the next one is anomalistic period. It is the orbital period of the Earth with its oblateness. It is defined as the time required to go around the orbital path from perigee to perigee. Its value is given as 2 pi pi n seconds. So here n is the mean motion, 2 pi is the 360 degree of its motion. So anomalistic period can be represented as 2 pi pi n seconds. Okay. Next, the oblateness of the Earth causes two rotational variations of orbital plane. The first one is regression of the nodes. The next one is rotation of apsides in the orbital planes. So let's discuss here each one here. Regression of the nodes. Here nodes represent ascending node and descending node which are present in the equatorial plane. Correct? So the nodes move along the equator. The line of nodes in the equatorial plane rotates about the center of the Earth. So due to the oblateness, it shifts the position of right ascension of the ascending node, that is omega angle. That means the nodes move in the opposite direction to the satellite motion. Simply backward direction. Okay. There are two kinds of orbits present in the satellite communication. One is prograde orbit, the next one is retrograde orbit. Prograde orbit means it is an orbit in which the satellite moves in the same direction as the Earth rotation. Earth is rotating like this. If the satellite is also moving in the same direction, then it is called as prograde orbit. If the satellite is moving in opposite direction with respect to Earth rotation, that is known as retrograde orbit. If the orbit is prograde, the nodes lie eastward. At the same time, satellites moves eastward. If the orbit is retrograde, the nodes lie eastward and satellites moves westward. That is simply opposite direction, that is rotational variations. So the next one is rotation of apsides. So it is occurred due to the argument of perigee changing with time. So what is argument of perigee? It is the angle from ascending node to perigee point in the orbital plane. Okay, so here we can get the value as d omega by dt is equal to k into 2 minus 2.5 sine square t. So here this k is the factor due to the oblateness. So here the factor due to oblateness is given as n into k1 by a squared into 1 minus e squared the whole power 2. It can be measured like this, radian per day. Here k value depends on n, that is mean motion, semi-major axis, as well as the eccentricity. The rate of change of right ascension of the ascending node is given as d omega by dt is equal to minus k into cos I. Here I represents the inclination value of the orbital plane. Okay, for a polar orbit its value is 90 degree, then the regression becomes 0. So here we can consider epoch time. Okay, so the one complete time period as t naught. For that, the right ascension of the ascending node value can be obtained as omega is equal to omega naught plus d omega by dt into t minus t naught. Similarly, here the argument of perigee omega is equal to omega naught plus d omega by dt into t minus t naught. So for each epoch time, we can calculate the omega values with respect to t naught. So next we are going to consider polar orbit. For this polar orbit, the regression value is 0 because the inclination angle is 90 degree. Okay, the rate of rotation of the line of apsides value is minus k by 2, that is half of the factor due to oblateness. The angle of perigee is minus k pa by 2. So here pa is what? Anomalistic period. Okay, then the time between the ascending nodes is given as pa into 1 plus k by 2n. Okay, so these are the values for polar orbit. Next one is equatorial ellipticity. Here the earth is not perfectly circular in the equatorial plane. So here we can consider this is the earth in the sense, this is the equatorial plane. It is not perfect circular plane. Okay, so due to this, it is having some effect called gravity gradient in the satellite orbit. So its small eccentricity, order of 10 to the power minus 5. So eccentricity defines the shape of the plane, correct? So here it is having a small eccentricity value of the order 10 to the power minus 5. Even this small eccentricity value has some effect called gravity gradient. It causes the satellites in geostationary orbit to drift to one of two stable points that are 180 degree separation on the equator. Those values are 75 degree east and 105 degree west longitude. So these two stable points are known as satellite graveyards. So these two points are very, very dangerous ones. So we have to avoid the drifting of satellites towards these two points using Station keeping method. So we are going to discuss this station keeping method in the next video lecture, okay, in detail. Okay, so the next one is atmospheric drag. It has significant effect on only low orbiting earth satellites just below 1000 km. So here drag is greatest at the perigee point. It is mainly used to reduce the velocity at the perigee point. The satellite does not reach the same apogee height on the successive revolution due to the drag. Drag means pull down the path. Okay, so if there is an orbit like this, there is a earth, so definitely it will track the perigee point from its original value. Okay, the semi-major axis and eccentricity both are reduced. The expression for the change of major axis is given as A is approximately equal to A naught into N naught by N naught plus N naught dash of T minus T naught the whole power 2 by 3. Here T naught is the reference time, A naught is the semi-major axis at the reference time, N naught is the mean motion at reference time, and here N naught dash is the first derivative of the mean motion. Okay, with respect to non-spheroid earth.